Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is the time for the annual search and rescue demonstration on Breakwater Beach and along the breakwater. You see already that one of the boats is getting itself in position, and we're gradually setting up ourselves to start about 5:15. As has happened before on this occasion, I regret to say the helicopter has withdrawn and we cannot use that today. Tremendous shame. We set this in up on the basis that it will come, but they're very, very busy over at Portland. Thank goodness we're quiet. Otherwise, our lifeboat would be away as well. Okay, so around about 5:15 we'll start, and the water's edge will be cleared by the Coast Guards in a little while now. There will be quite a bit of wash from the lifeboat once we're staying around. It's not. It will be quite rough on the water bed as we're near low water at the moment. Okay, so we'll come back to you again just before we start this thing. Okay.
You can hang
them
up in cheer.
Alan, very kind. I need my ears.
I just spotted a man with a yellow one. She had a tabard on. She's selecting for the Isle of Wight, so we'd ask you to be very generous to speak this afternoon. This is the end of our Lifeboat Week for 2008, and we hope you enjoy this afternoon for the display. At least you'll be seeing the Torbay Lifeboat crew working in every respect together with the Coastguard team from the air. Day 50 and things may not go according. I don't know if it was a big one they caught or whether they're trying to look 0-0-0. A little bit of something's gone a bit pear shaped. Oh my goodness, I think it's on fire. I think they've probably left the boat. Oh dear, I think the Coastguard have just taken a phone call. A 39 call, they call it. Brixton Coastguard, is that Brixton Coastguard?
Hello, this is Brixton Coastguard.
I think there's somebody in difficulty in the water.
Can you give me their position, please?
They're back 300 yards off Brixton Breakwater.
Right, main thanks. If you say you are, I'll send a mobile unit and I'll call the lifeboat.
Please say then, she's arrived in Bournemouth. Not far from our river, which is very nice.
The lifeboat coming in now is the Torbay lifeboat, as you all know, no doubt. The Alec Christina Dykes is coming in at about 25 knots, powered by 2,500 horsepower, and she can run for about 12 hours at that speed without requiring any more fuel. Her task scene now is to look for the casualties in the water. You can see one of the casualties is waving his arms furiously, which is a very good way of bringing attention to yourself if you are in that circumstance. Now the wash will come into the beach in a few minutes after he's up. And behind the all of the lifeboat, I didn't see it, the inshore lifeboat is also streaming in. There they are. I don't think inshore lifeboat does an awful lot of work around the beaches of Torbay. There you are, that's an easy way to get into a boat. And if you look at the all-weather lifeboat closely, you'll see a device that's known as the A-frame that's been put out. And it's basically a small frame pulled by the crew to then see the captain put the sea back into the boat. You have to look very closely, just to be sure. Here's one casualty in for the shore. Okay, here comes one casualty, or one into a lifeboat, one casualty to be greeted by the Coast Guard shore team. Thank you very much, isn't it? Yes, lovely job.